Hi, this is Dennis Toh from Flux TV. On Off the Beaten Track, I speak to Dave Lim from Summary Cafe, and he tells me more about the challenges faced as a cafe owner.
Hi, I'm Dave Lim from Summary Cafe, Parchment & Co. and Parchment Academy of Coffee and Tea.
So Dave, could you share with me more about the hardest track you had in life?
Well, the hardest track is starting Summary Cafe, definitely. Because I started without any experience. And I have I do not know how to cook, I do not know how to make coffee, make tea. So I started with zero experience and I just wrecked. And so when I first started, business is poor, cash is running out, and you have no way to reach out to customers. People just do not want to come to you. So you have to try a lot of different ways. So in the end, I decided that building up competency in-house is the best way to attract customers. That's why I went to study coffee, study tea, and subsequently win awards. And that's when people start to believe in us and start to come to us. Yeah, but when I first started, really is a one-man show. You do everything yourself. Because staff also, I mean, your workers also look at you and say, I think your shop is going to close down in no time. So maybe we shouldn't work with you. Uh-huh. Yeah, so people start to not work with you, start to leave. So you have to do a lot of things yourself. Mm. Yeah, so I was a floor, I was a kitchen, I was a dishwasher, I have everything. So it's really tough. And nobody shows you compassion because that's your business, you deserve it, you know. So, okay, I bite the bullet, went through, and luckily we put through 7 years. Mm. Yep.
How would you describe your childhood?
Childhood?
Yeah.
Normal, I think. Study, most of the time I study. But I was active in student council, also active in a bit of sports. I do taekwondo, swimming, all those things, canoeing. Mm. Yeah.
So you were the perfect student, excel in all areas in your life?
I wouldn't say that, but I do quite a diverse range of things. I do calligraphy actually also. I play piano. I learned to play the piano. Mm. In the past. Yeah. Mm. I stopped for a while. I joined a choir. So I did quite a bit of things. So perhaps that one toughened me up and allow me to learn multitasking and juggling different things in life. And that helps me a lot when I first started a cafe, because you are not only doing the cashier, not only doing the accounting, you're also planning about publicity, about what to post on Facebook and what's the meal for the next week and things like that. So you have planned a lot of things, so you have to plan on the go and be very, you are very tired, but your mind needs to remain alert. Yeah, so I think it helps.
I know that you were in the army for a while and then you went on to become a full-time entrepreneur as a cafe owner. What made you want to, you know, do a switch from being an army officer to a business owner?
Because I don't want to just see world from one view. Because the army actually pays you quite well. So I don't want to be in a position where you think that, oh, everything, the life is just a bed of roses, everything's okay. Even if I don't do very well in army, which is not true, because I think I did quite well. Even if I don't do very well, I'll still earn quite a decent amount, actually. So I think life shouldn't be seen from this just one lens. So I decided to come out and experience life from another angle. And that's when I really grow. That I see what's the truth on the ground. And I see how commoners, people who are poor, people who are struggling with life, people who are not so brilliant, people who are, you know, who has disability, live their daily life. Yeah, and I experienced a true Singapore, how customers treat you when you are an officer, high ranking, and how customers treat you when they do not know you are an officer and you are a waiter. Mm. Then you see the real things in life. Yeah. Mm.
So, can I just ask about the hardest thing that you need to really approach, you know, in a cafe? What's the hardest that you have to take on as a cafe owner?
Maybe manpower, because in a few sense, because firstly, looking for people ask me, why don't you hire like pretty ladies to work for you? I said that firstly, we don't have a queue of 20,000 people for me to choose, right? So this is just, people just come to you as and when, it's so sporadic and opportunistic. we have no, we really do not have a huge choice in who we employ. You know, when someone comes to me, we are very happy already. So I'm saying manpower is difficult because first you don't have a good choice of people. Secondly, is those people who come to you may not be a good job match. They may be students somewhere, but they may not have a experience or even the aptitude to be a good service provider, in a sense. Third is these part-time staff come to you because they want to earn money. They do not want to learn something, actually. Some really have good attitude, but you get a feel that really just here to make money, so they don't really care about how the business perform. Although I keep reminding them that actually what you do has an impact on the cafe, because they are full-time staff who depends on the salary to earn a living to feed off their family, you know. They understand the concept, but they didn't sink in. So they just, okay, I just work, time's up, I leave, that's it. Yeah. So it's, and on top of that, you need to train these people. And they do, because it's just a part-time job, right? Why do I need to learn so hard? Why should I suffer to do something for a cafe? I mean, when I'm working for like 2 months, 3 months during the holidays. Right, and fifth, Singaporeans are very demanding, super demanding. Yeah, when the price is high, they demand service. When the price is low, they demand more lower prices and high, cheaper things. And so it's really demanding. And given the first four factors that I said, it's very difficult to find someone who can match the number five factor, which is demanding customers. So you get complaints, and you really cannot solve it very much.
So the turnover rate is high because they are not able to keep up with the demands from Singaporeans as well.
So unless the supervisor or the boss has to be in the show, so the boss has to be not only the director in the show, he has to be an actor in the show as well, trying to pull people together and So that's why sometimes although when I'm on off days, which I don't really have actually, I still am in the cafe to watch over the staff. So there's this effect, if the boss is there, they tend to behave themselves more and they tend to put in more effort. Yeah, and they have more confidence. So it's a tricky effect actually.
Can I also say that chefs and cooks are one of the most difficult people to manage in this business.
Definitely true, man. We've got crazy chefs in the past who really think that they can destroy your business because they're the chef, you know, and they don't give you a face, even though you're a boss and you're a paymaster. Because to them, I've got skills. If I don't work with you, I can just go to another place to work. So what, you're the boss, I can just easily jump to an ending ship. So they are difficult to manage, but currently we are quite fortunate to have a team of very good chefs who are very committed, who do not count beans with you. Hey, time's up, my office is now, I need to go. Yeah, so we have quite a team of good chefs.
I know that when you first started, you actually fired two staff who refused to help you to clean the so-called the common area, right?
Not true, not the common area. So what happened was, that day was the eve of New Year. That was the New Year's Day countdown that PM Lee was here. Why? Because that year was due for election, 2011 was due for election, and Serangoon Gardens deemed to be a dangerous area. So PAP came down here to do a countdown.
Yeah.
So PM was here, so there's attracted a lot of people. So our cafe was en route to Serangoon Gardens, so people streamed past. But the thing is, after the countdown, when people walk past the cafe, they come in just for drinks and dessert. They don't really come in for a pasta or a steak or a fish and chip, because it's like midnight, you know, after the countdown, so it's past midnight. So the kitchen was not busy, but the front of the cafe, the floor staff was busy. So I asked the chef, hey, can you help to wash plates? Because so that everybody can knock off easier, and the front of the house is very busy, we have no time to wash. So the two young chefs told me, no, chef do not wash plates. I said that we just help us out because so that we can all knock off and enjoy New Year tomorrow. And anyway, New Year's Day, we are open.
Yeah.
Right, so just help everybody out.
They refuse.
They said, chef, do not wash plates. So if you don't know wash plates, then off you go. I just came back from army, so I had a bit of temper then. But now I'll totally tone down.
So that was you took on back then because of your training in the army. But if it happens today, would you have done the same thing?
No, because you, after having 7 years of roughing out in a cafe, really like I'm not as fiery as in the past. I see things at ease. I don't see things in perfect shape. And this is your job. You must help us. You must have moral compass. And I don't really feel that way nowadays for my stuff. Mm. So I just, okay, you don't want to do, it's okay, I'll do it myself. So nowadays, I really seldom like scold my stuff. The most I do is I would swan them, you know, I'm sarcastic a bit, but I don't really scold them because, if you cannot change your life and your life skill for so many years, you're like 20 years old, 30 years old, right? How could I expect you to change because you're doing a part-time job or just a full-time job here? I cannot expect, right? So I'll just do it myself. Like, instead of arguing with you, I do it myself, end of story there.
Mm. We all know cafe business come and go quite often, right? What is one critical ingredient in managing a successful cafe, in your opinion?
Hands-on, man. You need to...
So the owner has to be there, like...
Yeah. Small little things. For example, if the owner is there, it can avert a disaster from happening, you know. So, but if the owner is not there, the staff handles it badly, it can blow into a very big affair. People can give you one star and he can share with a lot of people. And Singaporeans know that Facebook one star doesn't really matter. I mean, that it's not totally true. But they on the other side, they believe it's true. For example, when you hunt for a cafe, you look at the star review.
Mm.
Yeah. Yeah, so I don't know. So that one matters ultimately. Yeah, so what I do is when I talk to the customers, when there's a disaster, I talk to the customers and tell them, explain the situation, usually they'll give a bit of face, lah. Because they see me every day at the cafe, so they know that you're putting in a lot of effort trying to make the cafe succeed. So they will give you a bit of face. But if I'm not around and the staff do something wrong, probably you'll burst, you know.
Mm.
Yeah, so sometimes really no choice. So people are asking me, if you are like always caged, so I call it a sunray cage, you know. Caged in a cafe, what's the point of opening a business, right? You're supposed to go around. I say, yes, it's true, but I don't think we are at a stage that I can just go around with a wine glass and travel the world yet. A business owner needs to take care of the business. Before it reaches that stage, you must still take care of the business, else you'll never succeed, and that's why a lot of cafes close down.
Mm-hmm. So after 7 years, right, what keeps you going?
You have to find new ways to, what keeps me happy is, because firstly, I'm doing something that I like. I like doing coffee, I like doing tea. So you need to keep expanding and deepening your competency. And I think that is interesting. So last year, we were the... 2 years ago, we were the best cafe. And last year, we were the tea champion. So with that, I managed to get my the AeroPress coffee champion to work with us. So in a sense, the cafe is building up competency.
Mm.
Then we changed the espresso machine to a bigger one, to a more... professional one, a spirit machine. So you can see that the cafe is growing and it's although it's baby steps, but it's still growing and customer can see. Say, oh, hey, your place now you serve better coffee. So that's a sense of satisfaction. And then you'll find that people, baristas, ask to work with you. Then you know that we are making progress, right? And so you need to expand. So now we're also doing a bit of sake. I mean, we at the school, we teach a bit of sake, wine, whiskey. Then you know that actually you're growing as a person. So the best way to stay passionate in your job is not just to work, it's to grow, it's to learn new things. And we find that as a cafe, we are learning new things.
So is that a strategy that you take on as and when you feel like it, or that you have sort of like a master plan, you know, a 5 or 10 year master plan that you set forth, or it's just something that comes along?